Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our main event. This match is for the New Zealand Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first. And his opponent, as I stated, the following match is scheduled for 1-4. And is for the New Zealand Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, standing to my right, representing the origin from the borderlands of Point Chiffin, weighing in at 78 kgs, James Shaw! And his opponent standing to my left, being accompanied to the ring by the most powerful man in New Zealand wrestling history, Mr. Daniel Burnell. He is from Taupo and weighs in at 85 kgs and is the current New Zealand heavyweight champion, Fury!
It's not your title, James Shaw. Get your hands off of that belt.
just as we start this match and ring the bell, can I point something out? I have a lollipop in my mouth. I think that strongly shows that I'm in the James Shaw camp.
James Shaw, number one. He's taking this home tonight, David.
You've been anything but an impartial broadcaster tonight, Binkertel. Where is your head?
What can I say? I'm liking fun. It's good. You know, I see two of the best wrestlers in New Zealand in this ring right here. And you know what? I think we need to have more fun around this place. We need less brutal attacks of people. Just, you know, more fun. And that is a championship reign by James Shaw.
How's this for fun? Fury heading out of the ring, going over, interacting with the fans, bringing the action right to your seat.
I don't call that interacting with the fans, David Dunn. I call that hiding. I call that, you know, playing mind games, getting James Shaw out of his comfort zone. And look, James, he's ready to fight. He's inviting Fury in. He's rubbing his bald head.
A new year and a new look for Fury with the shaved head, but look at that beard.
It's the furious beard of Fury. And look at this here, Fury just mocking James Shaw.
The champ wrestles when the champ wants, says Daniel Bernal.
James threatening to just boot him right where mini Furies come from. See? Magic! James Shaw's breaking away from the action, something different. We've got some magic going on. How can you not like this, David Dunn? How does he do that magic?
He's just flicking the bag.
Nope, he's not. Because he's using this one hand to throw it, the other hand to catch it. There's no way he can flick the bag. How does he do it, David? Magic, that's how.
I'm not surprised that baffles you, Ben.
They say, do you believe in magic? I believe in magic. I don't think Fury believes in magic. Do it. Now you've got to throw at the bag, Fury. You've got to throw at the bag. It's his fault. He screwed up that trick.
He's a wrestler. He's not a basketballer. He's not meant to throw like that.
That's all right. Now it's all fair. He's giving him another shot. But Fury doesn't want to play.
Watch, he'll get it this time. Oh, how's that for another shot? Exactly right. This is a wrestling match, not a magic show. I agree 100%.
What a scoop slam by James Shaw. James Shaw answering the call. If you want a wrestling show, he'll bring it to you with chops like that.
Well, Fury wasn't ready. He was still trying to get rid of the bag. That's not fair.
It's not my fault Fury got mad at a bag. And look at it now. James Shaw just been in control of this match this entire time.
It's just unnecessary, a back chop like that.
What? If you can deliver it, take it. And Fury goes flying over the top rope.
A hard landing for the champion.
I gotta say, James Shaw has had Fury's number this entire match.
Well, this is risky.
Oh, splash to the outside, knocks Fury down. And these fans are loving it. What? That's Mitchell Fell. Some call him the heart and soul of IPW. He's IPW's biggest fan, and what's he just crossed the guardrail?
Is this allowed?
What is going on? What other wrestler in this business would do that?
No one.
Mitchell,
for good reason.
He's getting a first-class viewing. One more time.
That's what happens when Shaw takes his eye off the ball like that.
Suplex to the outside. That hard concrete and wood has got no give on the outside.
Not at all.
Fury screaming. I don't know if you heard it. He said, fun time is over. Only a two count, though.
And here we go. Fury locks in a chin lock, just grinding away at Shaw. A lot of people overlook the damage you can do with a move like this, Ben. This can really just cut off your oxygen supply. It makes it hard to breathe. It makes it hard to recover.
And if anything, it takes the momentum out of you. I mean, you've got nothing left in you. It's hard to fight. But for James Shaw, with a suplex like that, he's got lots left in him. But so does Fury with a kick out. Stern kick there by Fury, followed up with another one.
Right to the back of the head. Oh!
Fist to the face. That's that closed fist we're talking about. Why come the ref didn't do anything there?
The refs have been somewhat lax on closed fists tonight, but I say let them. We've got the New Zealand heavyweight title on the line. I don't want to see a disqualification.
Well, if you remember James Shaw, he went through a battle against Jacob Cross at Fans Bring the Weapons last month. He earned the shot at the New Zealand Heavyweight Championship. And Fury wasn't at Nightmare Before Christmas. He was just fuming, planning, defending the title when he wants to. He was enjoying his time off while James was here with the fans.
You've got to imagine he was watching that match, though, and he must have enjoyed seeing some of the things that Jacob Cross did to James Shaw.
Huge back body drop there by Fury. And Shaw still got something left in the tank, able to kick out of that one.
Fury really looks to be dictating the pace of this match at the moment, though. Not sure if you can see on your monitor, Daniel Burnell polishing up the New Zealand Heavyweight Championship because he believes
sure it's
coming home.
Make sure it's nice and shiny for James Shaw, will you? Yeah.
For James Shaw? I don't think so.
Oh, kick to the face from James there. Oh, and a crossbody knocks the big man down. Fun fact, these two took each other on 3 years ago. It was the last time these two battled 3 years ago. Oh, it looked like a brainbuster reverse into a suplex there by Fury.
Fury, so versatile, able to just pull moves like that out of nowhere.
And the last time these two battled, Fury came out on top.
Fury was a winner.
However, this is a different Fury. And it certainly is a different James Shaw here tonight.
It's a different Fury. It's a more intense Fury. It's a more vicious, aggressive Fury.
Referee asking James if he wants to give up, but he isn't going to. He's still got some left in him. He's going to fight. He's going to fight till he can't fight no more. And this crowd firmly behind James Shaw.
A very partisan crowd. I don't think we've got a Fury supporter in the house.
Ah, but Fury cuts him off, gets into that corner, and look at him. He's been working the torso and the back of James Shaw this entire match. Why would you say he's been doing that, David Dunn?
Well, if you're familiar with James Shaw, one of his signature moves, the DVD, requires a lot of core strength to lift Fury up. And if Fury can weaken the core, can take that out of Shaw's arsenal, James has got nothing. He's got nothing left.
That is true. And right now, James is stuck in a very precarious, perverse place.
And Shaw trying to mount some sort of a comeback in the turnbuckles here.
Mr. Burnell just having a word to me there, saying I should be a little bit more of a fan of Fury, but I don't know.
As well you should be.
I'm not going to be told by the boss who to cheer for. I like these fans. I'm a fan of Shaw. He's a Shaw thing tonight. And that's a fact.
Well, he's certainly going high risk here.
Oh, what a somersault off the top rope there. Fury gets all of it. Can we get a replay of that? Yep, that's 85 kgs of pure power by James Shaw coming off the top rope here.
Right,
it's back
the
in the ring.
Section.
Conan is up to a 3 count.
Fury, the first man back to his feet.
Oh, but James the first one to attack. Rolls him over and hits him with a huge neck breaker there. And James is fired up. This is the Shaw power we talk about. Oh,
how's that for a furious elbow?
How's that for a reversal? Looks like Fury was going for something. Electric chair drop reversal.
You want to talk about a reversal.
Into a victory roll there.
Fury calling for the brainbuster.
Slice bread number two!
Shawshank Redemption! My goodness.
My apologies, that is the Shawshank Redemption. Fury did not see that one coming.
He did not. Fury's just stacked up on top of himself.
And this could be it. One, two. Oh. Only a two count. We were reaching for the bell there, folks. That was so close.
Definitely the closest fall we've had all match.
And now Fury, Shaw's going to be thinking. He's got to be thinking it's time to put him away. And it's time to end this. The crowd's ready to rock you. And James Shaw ready to rock Fury.
He's signaling for it.
Could we see the DVD? He's got him up. He's ready to go. Conan's been knocked down. James Shaw checking on the referee.
Oh, right to that midsection. He's been working over.
Oh! Brainbuster! Explosive brainbuster there by Fury.
Very impressive from the champion, but of course our referee has been knocked down in that kerfuffle.
And here we go, it's Fury going to the top rope here. Shooting star!
Oh my goodness!
Time to connect with it! Can we get a replay of that?
Phenomenal!
Shooting star twist with a twist and nobody home. James Shaw just have the knowledge to roll out the way. All 3 men are down, and I'm talking about the referee as well.
What? Jacob Cruz!
He has no part in this match. What is going on? Kingslayer! Jacob Cross is inserting himself in this match and hitting James Shaw, that massive Kingslayer.
You are going to die now.
This violent monster. And what's... Fury's telling Jacob that this is his match.
These two are investment teammates. Daniel Burnell's really not happy.
What is going on here?
Well, I'm as confused as anyone right now, Ben. Is this a breakdown of the investment?
It appears so, as Fury is furious at Jacob Cross for inserting himself into this match.
Cross appears to have crossed Fury, coming in and interfering.
Burnell, the voice of reason for once in his life, pulling Cross out of the way. And what's this?
Oh, watch out, collision on the apron.
What a roll-up! This could be it! One, two! Oh, so close. And he's got him up. Oh, he gets to a DVD!
Driver.
Pin him! He also knows to go off to Shaw. Go off to Cross. Cross is flying to the outside. James has got to follow up. James has got to pin him. We could see a new champion tonight, David.
I don't want to say it, but we could.
The investment just imploding on the outside as Shaw just crawls to Liam Fury.
And this Cross could be retreats it. Backstage.
This could be it. Come on. One, two. Damn it.
His foot on the ropes.
Damn it. If he had been a second quicker, that referee had been a second quicker, this match would be over.
It would, but he wasn't, Ben. The match continues.
And James is to his feet. He's calling for it.
Watch out, Fury. He's behind you.
If this second DVD connects, it is over. And what?
Oh
what
my
is
goodness!
This? Looks like he's going some sort of torture rack.
Oh!
Fury able to counter that into a machine head. And now, the Talpo Cray. This is the Talpo Cray, the same maneuver that put away Alfred Valentine, the same maneuver that put away Travis Banks. Will it put away Liam James Shaw?
He's sitting down. He's certainly got a lot of pressure on the hold, right on the lower back of Shaw. He's been working over for most of the match. This has got to be excruciating right now.
Yeah, reach, boy. Reach.
Shaw's a long way for the ropes. He's really
Think
in trouble
Think about the
here.
Last 8 years. Think about all that effort you've put in. Think about your future. This is your moment. Reach for those ropes.
This does not look good for James.
Come on, James. Come on. He's still alive! James Shaw is still alive! And he grabs it! He has grabbed the ropes, David Dunn!
I am dumbfounded right now.
But Fury just very late to the game breaking that hold. Both men did not see that coming. What's going to be going through the head of Fury right now? He's thinking, what do I have to do to put away James Shaw?
He does look at a loss. Well, there's you go. There's his plan. I'm going to break your neck, says Fury.
What is he going for here? Machine head Mac 2. Fury able to counter it. Pile driver!
Oh my goodness.
Massive pile driver there by James Shaw. Got to follow up. He's got to go for that pinfall.
What won't these two do to each other?
Nothing. The answer to that question is nothing. They will do everything it takes to become the New Zealand heavyweight champion. And what's this? Oh, no, what is this? It's those brass knuckles.
We saw those earlier tonight with Kurt Chaos.
This is a damn good match. I don't need it ruined by Daniel Burnell. And here he is! Here's our former boss, Dion McCracken. Oh, with elbows of his own. He is giving. He was giving Daniel Burnell his right comeuppance. And these two here just slugging it out in the corner. Get out of the ring, you two. What?
The referee has declared this match is a no contest.
Nobody in this arena, whether investment, origin, fan, doesn't matter, nobody is happy with that result.
I hate to see that.
No, that's just awful.
What a competitive match brought to an end. Daniel Burnell and Dion McCracken.
Unfortunately, and these two are just beating the crap out of each other in the ring now. As a result, still New Zealand heavyweight champion, Fury. James Shaw will get another shot. This isn't over. Mark my words, this isn't over between James Shaw and Fury.
As a result, still your New Zealand heavyweight champion, Fury!
I hated saying that, especially after a match like this that was so competitive, so enthralling, so different, and it just ends like that. Even you mustn't be happy about that, David Dunn.
I'm disappointed, but there is the prospect these two may have a rematch. We may see them fight again. I want to be there.
They
I want to see that.
They would have to have a rematch again. And look at James Shaw.
Let's just hope we can keep Dion McCracken out of the mix.
Hell of a match. Hell of a match between these two. Unhappy about the ending, but it's a hell of a match. I hate to end the first show of 2015 like that, but ladies and gentlemen, thank you for purchasing this IPW DVD. Make sure you grab all the other IPW DVDs out there. September selection, Rival Turf, the whole kit caboodle. My name is Suavison Venkatel. He's Wellington's finest, David Dunn. Anything left to say before we sign off?
Good fight, good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming out tonight to Year of Conflict 2015. Let's give it up for James Shaw.
We'll get him next time, huh? I said we'll get him next time! Thanks for coming, everyone. See you in April.
That's right, the next IPW live event, April 18th, the Rush for Gold, right here at the Mount Albert War Memorial Hall. Start time 7 p.m. Hope to see you there.